everybody. So it's 9:30, and the only thing I've seen are that doe and buck fawn that were they showed up around 8:45-ish. I just saw them again. They ran back here. It's like they were spooked or something. And then the buck fawn lost where his mom was, so he kept running back and forth. But it's pretty cold today. I'm pretty underdressed. I'm going to try and stick it out till 10. I guess I'll see you guys at 10. Buddy, so it is 10:40, and that was a really interesting experience. So I was recording these. I think they're two twin fawns. One was a buck, one was a doe. And then from another pathway, this yearling buck comes in, and he walks into the center, and I'm recording him, and then all of a sudden, he kind of like puts his ears back, and postures up, and I thought he was like wanting to fight the yearling, the fawn buck, but it seems like he did that to try and like attract the doe fawn. And he kind of chased her a little bit, but I don't think she is in heat, so I think he realized that, and then he settled down a little bit. But that was a really cool experience. I'm thinking I might get out of here early today, around 11. Hopefully that does not bite me in the butt, but as long as nothing else comes in, this will probably be the last update for today. I will see you guys later. Everybody, so my camera died, so I'm having to use my phone to record this. Crazy end of the hunt. There was a bobcat that literally just was, you know, right down in there, and he was so quiet I didn't hear him. But I was able to get footage of him. That was really crazy. Or her, I don't know if it was a boy or a girl bobcat, but I've never seen a bobcat that close up in person, so that's really cool, and I hope you guys think it's cool as well. So this is the end of my hunt today, November 15th. I will definitely probably be back here in a couple days. There's some good weather days that I want to take advantage of before the rut ends. So I'll see you guys then.